Marks a big day in the history of the Madison Police Department, a day some also say is critical to its future. The chief unveiled the department's own training center for recruits. NBC 15's Dana Bruick was there for a peek at the facility.
This former printing company is the Madison Police Department's new training center. Madison's police chief, mayor, and local alder cut the crime scene tape to unveil the $2 million acquisition. This year's recruit class is the first to use the 30,000 square foot facility. The department used to rent far less space at MATC at a cost of $50,000 per year. Now recruits can practice scenarios in the yet to be converted warehouse. Previously, they'd practice situations like this one almost anywhere.
Literally, wherever we could find space, and because of a limited budget, especially donated space so that we wouldn't have to pay for it, that would work really well for us.
But there's still work to do. The warehouse space is expected to undergo a three-phase renovation.
I can tell you that in my future capital budget starting next year, you'll see the additional commitments of capital expenditures to complete the facility inside.
The first phase, slated for this year, will provide classrooms and locker rooms at a cost of $800,000. The second phase, a $2 million addition for an indoor shooting range next year.
The ability for the Madison Police Department and other agencies to tap into a range that can be used 24/7 is remarkable.
And it's seen as a way to generate revenue. Now recruits use Dane County's outdoor range and travel to Janesville for indoor training.
Our training officers were in different places. Our training staff was in different places. We're going all over to train. And that, so from an efficiency standpoint, this is important.
Captain Sue Williams says the opportunities are endless, with even outdoor space for training the department's four-legged members. In Madison, Dana Bruick, NBC 15 News.
Phase three of the renovation calls for an auditorium, computer lab, as well as fitness and tactical training areas. It would be completed in 2012. Additional funding for renovations still needs to be approved.